Hello students, today we will be discussing about the continuation of the first practical which I had given you in the last week. There we had studied about the introduction of compound microscope and we had discussed about the parts of compound microscope. Today I will be showing you the dissection box which is required for your PUC1 practicals and what are the equipments required in the dissection box. So, dissection box, you can purchase it in the nearby bookstores. There are two types of dissection box, the companies. One is Cynic, which I have now, I have it with me. Another one is about the company, that is Camel. So you have to purchase the dissection box and you have to make sure that what are the requirements in the dissection box, so which is very important for your biology practicals. So here you can see that this is the dissection box and there are different equipments present in the dissection box. So starting with glass, okay, here this is the glass slide. I have two glass slides in this dissection box. So these are plain glass slides, okay, and at least there should be 2 to 3 slides in the dissection box. Usually when you purchase the dissection box, there will be presence of only one glass slide, but you have to purchase at least 3 glass slides separately. Here I have kept one more type of glass slide. If you just notice it, you can see there is a cavity in the center. We use this glass slide for the second year practicals. For first year practicals, we need plain slides. Then this is the watch glass. You can see there are two sized watch glass, one is bigger one, the other is small. So to prepare the stain we need this watch glass, okay, and slides are used where we do the mounting. Whatever specimens sectioning is done, it is done on this glass slide, and to prepare the stain we use this, or if you want to take any water, it can be used for many purpose. So you can see it is, this is the watch glass. Then in the dissection box, you have this magnifying glass. If there is any microscopic or anything which cannot be seen with the naked eyes, you can make use of this magnifying glass. You can see that it is getting magnified. Okay, so there's a magnifying lens in this dissection box. Then there is a blade here. This is the normal shaving blade which is required for your first year practical. Every time whenever you do the sectioning, it is must that you have to get a new blade. You should not use the used one. Blade is very important because sectioning of plant, that is dicot and monocot, stem, root, you need to take very fine sections. So we need, this is about the blade, okay. And coming to one more, this is the cover slip. In a dissection box, there will be a box which consists of cover slips. You can see they are very delicate glass which are called as cover slips, okay. You people have to purchase one box, because when you purchase a dissection box, there will be presence of only one cover slip, but you need a whole box, so you have to purchase it separately. There will be many cover slips in a given box, around 20 cover slips will be there. So you need to purchase because they are very delicate and they break during the dissection. So you need to have spare. Then coming to the other equipments which are there, there will be 2 forceps. You can see this is the blunt forceps. It is having blunt ends, you can see it. And there is one more forceps which is called as pointed. You can see there are 2 pointed forceps. These are very important for dissection, to hold any section or to hold any delicate. You can't hold it with your hands, you need to use this forceps to prepare the slide. Then this is the wind blower, okay, mainly used for dissection. Once you start the practical, you will get the exact idea where, at which point you will be using these equipments. Then this is the This is the brush, simple paint brush. You don't have it in the dissection box. Students have to purchase it separately, and we prefer the brush should be of zero number because you need to hold the sections, so you need zero size brush. Then there is a dropper to take the stains or to wash the excess stain. You need the dropper. This also you will get it in the bookstall. Yes, this is about the practical, and this is about the equipments which are required in your dissection box. You have to purchase it, and this is the dissection box. And coming to other things which you use during the practicals is about the slides. Here you can see these are permanent slides. Okay, now the question arises, how the permanent slides are prepared. You can see this is also a simple glass slide, and you can see a cover slip on the top, but beneath the cover slip you can see the section. If you are able to see it, you can see a pink color section in this. This is a section of TS of cartilage. So it is an animal tissue where they have taken the section of a cartilage, and it is fixed permanently with the help of a fixative. There is a substance called as fixative. If we use the fixative, the section will get fixed in its fresh condition. It will not undergo decomposition. So there are different fixatives used. So this is about the cartilage transfer section. TS means transfer section of cartilage. Like this, we have transfer section of monocot leaf. Then we have the transfer section of dicot root. These all are permanent slides. In biology lab, we have such many permanent slides which can be observed under the compound microscope, and you can understand what is the internal structure of these sections. Now, this is the holder. When you do physiology tests, like test to detect the presence of carbohydrates, proteins, fats, you need to make use of this holder. This holder is also useful in chemistry lab. You'll be using it in chemistry lab also, as well as in the biology labs. Then, coming to the stains, we are using different stains. For PUC1, if you focus on PUC1 practicals, we make use of saffron stain. Very commonly used stain in PUC1 practical. We need to dilute this and use it for staining. And as well as we'll be using acetocarmine. This is concentrated one. We need to dilute it and we put it in the dropping bottles. Okay, and we make use of this. One more important thing, whenever you do any sectioning, mounting, we also make use of these blotting papers. Okay, to remove the excess stain or to keep your slide clean, we need to use the blotting papers, or you have to use clean cloth which can be used, very important. Then this is about the dissection box and permanent slides and stains. Here I just want to show you some permanent specimens, preserved specimens. You can see the name of the specimen is labio. It's a common name. It's a freshwater fish. It's a preserved fish, labio. The scientific name of this fish is Labio rohita. Now, you may ask me, what is the chemical used in this preserving this specimen? It is formalin. It is formalin. Formalin is nothing but formaldehyde, which is diluted in the water. It is 37% of formaldehyde, which is termed as formalin. Why we are using formalin is, because if we use formalin, it will not undergo decomposition. It will remain fresh in this chemical. So you can see I have kept many specimens here, live specimens which are preserved in formalin. This is frog. The scientific name of frog is Rana tigrina. Then you have a plant or a fungus, mushroom. Okay. Agaricus is the scientific name of the mushroom. Then there is a fern. Ferns, you find it very common, but we also have preserved this in the formalin. It comes under Pteridophyta. Okay. These are the ways how we preserve the specimens some are on the slide, some are in the bottles. There's one specimen here, a rat. This rat is kept in the jar. It is here also we have used the preservative. We have used the preservative, and it is a stuffed specimen which is kept in the bottle. Okay. So in this way, you'll be studying about different organisms in the biology lab, and you will get the idea how the specimens are preserved and what are the characteristics of the specimens. Okay, as well as the slides also. What is the internal structure of dicot and monocot, root, stem, and leaf? You'll get the exact idea how the what type of cells are present, what is the tissue, and so on. I hope you have understood today's practical, and thank you for watching the